This past weekend, the Dayton Dutch Lions FC Academy took part in the Seamus Rustin Memorial Cup in Michigan, with 8 of the Academy teams participating. The U11 girls entered the cup with high hopes and was looking forward to seeing competitors from across the Great Lakes. Before the first game, Dutch Lions TV caught up with coach Eric Kissinger to discuss the upcoming weekend.
We're looking to play some good soccer. You know, we've heard a lot of good things about the tournament. The Waz is a big name up in Michigan, so hopefully we get a lot of good competition. We get some good time for our players. We only have one sub today, so we're going to be rotating in and out quite frequently, but it'll be a good experience. In this type of situation, you just have to focus on what your team can do. So we're going to focus on our style. We're going to try to possess the ball. We're going to try to keep it. And if the other team has something that's truly out there that we need to adjust to, we'll make that change. We got to keep, you know, we got to keep everything light. We got to keep it easy. We got to give them rest in between. Keep snacks coming, and above all, just, you know, keep a positive attitude. Katie, center.
Katie.
Dulcie, wide right. Nina, up top. Kate, wide left. We'll get Lauren in shortly. We have only one sub, which means I'm going to be subbing every 2, 3, 4, 5 minutes. So if you come off shortly, don't think it's because I think you're playing badly. It's because I want to keep everybody fresh. We want to keep the subs going, okay? Lions on three.
One, two, three, Lions!
Go, Lions!
Hit it, Morgan.
Oh.
For the Barry family, who have 3 children in the academy, one of the most memorable experiences from this past weekend was the drive of the kids to compete.
Probably seeing the kids never give up. They just fought and fought and fought for every ball. Each team played 4 games, and through all 4 games, you know, they were, especially by the end, they were just exhausted and they were still trying, still fighting for every possession. It was really good.
Yeah, they're really, really enjoying themselves with the Lions.
I think especially this academy is going to be great for development. Just the skills they're teaching as basics starting out, and seeing the older teams that have been here for a while, and knowing that they started with the same basic level and they've worked up to a higher skill level, and seeing how that's developed is amazing. And I don't really see that in some of the other leagues that are around that aren't really club oriented and aren't really development oriented. They're just, you know, you play at whatever age level your kids are and you go. This one, you can really see the development from year to year and age group to age group.
To help keep the girls' legs from getting tired, Coach Eric changed formations at halftime to limit the amount of running the girls needed to do.
All right, let's go, ladies. Lions on three.
One, two, three, Lions!
To end game one, the girls scored a late equalizer, setting the tone for a strong weekend performance. For 2 of the U11 girls, being friends with their teammates off the field has helped with their performance on the pitch.
Yeah, we can like trust each other more and know what we're gonna do as a team.
Yeah, like we know what we're gonna do next in games, so we practice and then we know what we like in games, so it really helps us.
Lauren's twin, Kate, has also learned quite a bit in her short time with the Dayton Dutch Lions.
Well, I've learned juggling a little bit more, and scissors and all, a lot of fancy moves.
I liked the pizza party at the hotel.
For Julie Takahashi, she wouldn't go anywhere but the Dayton Dutch Lions when it comes to soccer development.
Oh, we love the Dutch Lions. Wouldn't be anywhere else. I would say there is nothing like the Dutch Lions coaches. They're amazing. They do anything for your child, give them confidence, teach them skills they haven't learned anywhere else. They come to your games even if they're not your coach. couldn't ask for anything better. Well, we were nervous starting out because the girls are used to, you know, looking up the teams, figuring out who their competition would be. But it was an experience. I mean, my older daughter played a team from Canada, and they were huge and strong and a little intimidating. But for the most part, I felt like our skills really stood up to all the other teams there.
From 4 games in 2 days to swimming in the pool and having a pizza party in the hotel lobby, the U11 girls had a great weekend they are sure to remember for a long time.